Good evening, ladies and gents. Very welcome to another episode of The Lot on this wonderful Wednesday evening. How is everybody?
Pretty good, thanks.
Oh,
are we asking me?
Yeah, how are you, Ben?
Fabulous, thank you.
Sorry, we're a little bit late tonight. Ben was brushing his hair. It's a lovely job.
Yeah, it didn't work.
As always, we like to get straight in here with a bit of a warm-up one. So this one is a great old Dublin street ballad in E minor for anyone playing along at home. And there'll be a lovely chance to get a solo on this after the third chorus. So if you're not familiar with it, you got three verses and choruses to go before we get there. Are we ready?
Yes.
This is called A Hot Ashfelt, and it goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Jolly lads, I'm glad to find you well. If you get them all around me, know the story I will tell. For I have this situation, big or a handy gob, I can whisper my the weekly wage of 19 bob. This 12 months come October since I left me native home, after helping in Killarney boys to bring the harvest down. And now I wear a Yancy and around me waist a belt. I'm a gaffer in the squad to stay in the hot Ashfelt. Copper came and says to me, McGuire, would you kindly let me light me pipe down at your miler fire? He flanks himself with pounding, his hobnails up to lace. Says, I'm a decent man, you better go and mind your base. He ups and yells and down on you, I'm up to all your pranks. I know you for a traitor from the Tipperary ranks. I kiss him on the shoulder, I gave him such a belt that I knocked him into the boiler full of the hot ash belt. Oh, holy lady! A devil the thing it hardened, it turned him hard as stone. And with every other murmur, you could hear the copper groan. I'm thinking, says O'Reilly, he's looking like old Nick. And for me, if I'm not inclined to claim him with me pick, well, says I, it might be easier to pile him till he melts and to star him nice and easy into the hot ash belt. Oh, he laid it in the hollows and we laid it in the flats. And if it doesn't last forever, sure, I'm there, I need me hat. Well, I wonder. Sailor lad, ballad singers and the rest. Your shoemakers are your tailors, what he plays the ladies best. The only ones who know the way to 50 hearts and belt are the lads around the boiler making the hot ash belt. When robbing and a scrubbing, I caught me desk to call. For scientific purposes, me body it was old. In the Kelvin coat, you see me boys, I'm hanging in me pelt. As a monument to the paddies making the hot ash belt. Holy lady! And we're off.
I'm just going to adjust the chair here.
We hope you're all getting warm there.
Am I going the right way?
Looks great, man. Keep her lit. Yeah, that looks right.
Ah, good.
So we got when we assemble these shows, ladies and gents, we always tend to find accidental themes. And
we noticed that everybody, for the exception of Kevin, is doing blowing some kind of wind instrument. So this is a particularly windy edition. I suppose after our storm on Sunday, it's kind of apt.
On top of that, there's a lot of hornpipes.
There's a lot of hornpipes coming at your way.
Two eddies.
Two eddies. A packet of Jaffa cakes. So it's all going off here.
Cheers, everybody.
I want to kick off by thanking our wonderful players from last week. We've got, would you believe it, 7 guests coming up in this next show. So we've got Bindi on concertina. We've got Neville Smith all the way from Singapore doing some reels for us there on whistle. We've got Dennis Grattan on accordion. And then we've got, like you said, 2 types of eddies. We've got our friend
Swords.
Our friend Eddie Nolan, who's a wonderful piper from Brisbane. And we're going to be rolling back a couple of his hornpipes from a few weeks ago. And then we also have a novice to the show. We've got Mr. Eddie Kavanagh, who we are lucky to have in the studio with us tonight. Say hello, Eddie.
If we had more cameras, we'd pan to him.
Yeah, the budget didn't stretch for an extra camera. So Eddie's got, he's a lovely, well, he's a multi-instrumentalist to play. Is tin whistle and low whistle and banjos and guitars and all sorts of stuff. So we're delighted to have him here in the studio. There's not enough room to get him on camera, but if you're going to stick around...
I knew that would be the first question. They're just like, well, just get him
just
up
get
here.
Him
it's a small room.
And with many instruments.
We'll work it out one day. But
yes,
yeah.
And for people who are sticking around for the after show as well, the post-show thing that we do afterwards, we're going to be chatting away to Eddie. So if anyone's got any special messages for him, just stick on with us for the after show. We also have Kevin and Didna, who have done a couple of tunes. We're gonna lash a few of those out. Ben's having trouble with his chair there.
It's very important chair height, you know.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off with our first guest, and this is the wonderful Nev Smith, all the way from Singapore. Nev played some fabulous reels a few weeks ago.
And they were just so jaunty, we had to bring him back.
Yeah, Nev is such a tasteful player, and we've really enjoyed playing music with him any time that we head to Singapore. So these reels are just some nice ones to get warmed up against the Silver Spear, maybe behind the bar, and Father Kelly's. So if anyone doesn't know the format yet, in order for us to be able to hear Neville, we've got to put on these things, and then we're going to play along.
We have a direct line to Singapore here.
That's exactly what it is. So we're getting settled in. Let's get this
let's
one
do the
going.
Thing.
Are we ready?
No, let's do it.
Here we go. Thank you.
On you, Nev.
Oh, beautiful. Come on, Nev. Lovely stuff.
For anyone who knows the last tune, there's a part right at the end there that's unorthodox. And Neville's just such a creative man. He's just always sticking in something, just slipping in a little bit of a side note there.
A bit of style there. Yeah. Yeah, that's great. It's great. So well played. Thanks for those, Neville. Oh, that's great. So we're going to move on to a set of tunes that we wanted to play for you for a long time. And just haven't got the opportunity, and it sprung into our heads today. So these next tunes were written by a friend of ours called Mark Joyce, a proud Cork man who does frequent the sessions whenever he's in town. And
a fantastic composer.
Wonderful. Yeah. And he's composed so many great tunes, and he just keeps bringing out these great hornpipes and polkas. And so we're going to play a couple of his tunes here. And these are our first set of hornpipes, aren't they, officially?
Ah, that's right, yeah, it's the remembering that it's the night of the hornpipe.
Yeah.
Sounds ominous.
So I think Bindi, who is going to be coming up in the programme very shortly, this is one of her favourite sets. When she heard it first, she was like, oh, I've got to learn these. So these are known as Joyce's hornpipes. They're official titles of Bindi here. The first one's called The Tinker's Cross, and it kind of goes from D minor into D major. And the second one's called John Wayne's Gatling Gun. That was not its original title. The original title was The Rebel in the Hedge, which is my preferred title.
Yeah.
But Mark Joyce insists on it John Wayne's Gatling Gun. And I guess when you hear the tune, you'll probably figure out why.
It's self-evident.
So take it away, Ben. These are a couple of originals from Mark Joyce. Here we go. Mark Joyce for letting us play those. We really enjoy playing. I don't know if Mark is watching tonight.
We heard those at Fenians, yeah.
Unreal. Well, we hope you are watching there, Mark, and thank you for that. As always, we got the wonderful Caroline at the helm, so if you got any messages or questions or just want to say that you're listening and playing along, I'm sure she'd love to hear from you. So that was awesome, man. Let's move on to our second guest of the evening, and we hinted at it a little bit earlier.
I didn't actually think that through the last one. I was like, oh yeah, I'm just going to play a million triplets.
That was great. Dun-dun-dun-dun.
Yeah, well, that's it. And then play a set of heavy reels.
These are some beautiful reels that Bindi sent in to us here. We've got the Drunken Landlady. We got the Shannon Breeze. I struggled to find that one under that title in the session. So I found it under Rolling in the Rye Grass for anybody who wants to check
As
it
Mark
out.
As Mark Joyce has proved, a tune can have many names.
Even from the same author.
Yeah.
So if you don't get the Shannon Breeze on the session.org, you'll get it there as Rolling in the Rye Grass. And then the last one there, the Red Haired Lass. So we'll give these a lash here from Bindi. As always, got to peg these things on.
I think we're heading to Rolling Stone now, is that right?
I think so, yeah. Direct line Rolling Stone. All right, here we go. Thank you. Thank you for those. Such cracking tunes. They're brilliant.
It's a great set.
Lovely set. Really, you were saying like how well put together it is from the point of view of like
Phrasings. There's little nuggets in the first tune that relate to the next one and so on to the third one. And that makes a great set. Yeah.
Lovely. Lots of thought put into that one. Thanks for those, Bindi. So we're going to move on now with a song. As I clear my throat.
Is this thing on?
This is one of our favourites to pull out of the session. It's a great one that everyone can play along with. Hopefully it's in the key of G if you're playing along at home with us. And it's a song about three schoolboys that got the shock of their lives. They thought when school was over that they could just lounge around the house and have the crack. That was not the case. Another set of tunes that we did a couple of weeks ago, and these are a beautiful set of hornpipes from the wonderful Eddie Nolan, also known as Eamon O'Noolan, and he's a fabulous piper.
I just saw another set of his tunes, another tune on Facebook this morning. Unreal.
Oh, right. Deadly. Yeah. So if you love Ilan Pipes or just great Irish music played at an expert level, check out his Facebook page, Eamon O'Noolan, Ilan Pipes. And he was good enough to send us these hornpipes there a few weeks ago, so we're going to roll them back again. Two fabulous ones that we really enjoyed playing. So these are known, the first one's the Taylor's Twist, and then we have Alexander's. I think they're both in D. Oh no, both in, are they in D? Yeah.
D for don't know.
D for heaps of drones. So here's some wonderful hornpipes from Eddie Nolan, the first Eddie of the night.
Awesome, what a set.
Thank you, man. So much fun to play those ones. We hope you enjoyed those as well. It's great to be creating a big backlog of these great tunes from people, you know.
I for one have learned that apparently, so we're trying to get more family friendly. A buttload of tunes. Since we've been starting this. So
and if anyone's not aware, tomorrow, once we wrap tonight and we go home and cry for a while, and then tomorrow we put the...
I already am home. Can I start crying now?
we put the videos up on YouTube with all the indexes of all the stuff. So for anyone that wants to go and check back over them. So I think we've got another guest coming up, man. Another way to do a hornpipe. I'm going to let you introduce this one. Well, we got good crack out with this, in fairness, on Sunday when we did our pirated edition of the...
It was totally... We had Dennis in, like, and he... We got him in for a specific set of polkas that we did a couple of weeks ago. or last week, was it? And
yeah.
And then, but once we had him in, we milked him for all he was worth. and
he loved it.
I don't know if he did or not, but I mean, look at that smiley head.
Look at that tiny accordion.
that's an inappropriately sized accordion. He has a much larger one.
So you guys might know this as the theme tune for Captain Pugwash. And its official title is called The Trumpet. So this is another way to do a hornpipe. We love this one. We really enjoy playing along.
So the reason they call this a trumpet hornpipe, I imagine, is because of, like, on the trumpet you do the triple tongue.
It's a proper music knowledge coming through there.
I just made that up. It may be true, maybe not.
Anyone who wants to dispute that, please dispute it at length in the comment section.
No, I'm no doctor.
All right, here we go. Here's Dennis with the trumpet hornpipe, Captain Pugwash. Here
Brace
we go.
Yourselves.
In research of that tune, we found a lovely version of John Sheehan and Barney McKenna from the Dubliners playing that in a set. And
two mandolins together.
Oh,
yeah,
it's just gas.
You've got to look it up. It's unreal.
Just
yeah,
the
yeah.
smiley heads in them when they're playing that tune.
Yeah, I think
it
was like the 70th anniversary or whatever, something like that, or 50th or whatever.
Oh, yeah, the run of gigs they did in the Gazy. Yeah, yeah. Check it out on YouTube. If you type in Captain Pugwash. It
ends with
the
Mullingar races as well.
That's right. Have you ever been?
I have.
Fancy
time. Once or twice. Twice.
So now we've got a bit of a request that we're going to send out to a friend of ours called Mark Black. I bumped into Mark down the coffee shop in Bayswater today, and I said I'd see if I could get a sneaky song in for him. So he's a big fan of the Waterboys, as are we. So we're going to do a little love song, send it out to Mark and MJ. Oh yeah, Eddie, that's all right. You can come this way. Keep coming, Eddie. Hey!
Oh, we've got our environment, hey? Straight out of JB's.
Thank you very much for Eddie, but that's a lousy pint, you know. It definitely did not come from JB O'Reilly. It's a pouring great pints down there. So this one is for Mark and MJ, and we're going to do, it is traditional in this tune to do a little bit of the Calliope House. So, controversial tune because it was written in the key of E. And,
Is that where it started? Oh, Kevin,
originally it was written in the key of E, and written by a guy called David Richardson. I was doing my homework today. He was from a band called The Boys of Lock. It was about a place in Pittsburgh called Calliope House, or Calliope House, depending on how you pronounce it.
Yeah.
And they were great supporters of folk music, and apparently Dave and the band would go over there and do a heap of gigs. So he wrote this tune and kind of dedicated it to the place. Normally it's done occasionally it's done in E, occasionally it's done in D. We're going to do it in D, and I'm sure we're going to get plenty of complaints from the fiddle players.
If you don't like it, you put a capo on your computer.
Does that even work?
I don't think so.
Oh, that's great. Oh, this bazooki's going to have a tune, man.
Once again, like last week, because it's starting to get chilly in here, we heat up the room a lot at the start, but we have to turn the heater off because it makes an awful bloody racket.
Worse racket than us.
I mean, flaming racket. I'm getting better at it. slightly.
All right. So this song is called "A Man Is in Love," and we're going to do after the second verse, we'll do a run through of the Calliope House in D, and then we'll come back at the end of the song and give it a twice through. So it goes like this. Ben,
it's deceiving that one there because the tune's like and then it's like I've got to play the tune now. It's a billion miles an hour.
We played that one night in Geraldton, absolutely steaming. It was great crack.
I remember that. Can't be true. Well, maybe that's precisely why it is true.
So now we're going to welcome back a duo to the programme, the wonderful duo of Kevin and Dibna. Kevin, the only man here playing a string in the whole place tonight.
Aside from us, he's got our backs.
Yeah, fair play, Kev, represent. Yeah. Kevin and Dibna are going to do a lovely set of modern jigs.
So much so that I made a couple of mistakes while I was learning them. I was like, oh, hang on a sec, this sounds like Black Sabbath.
Yeah. These are terror. So they were written by a fellow from Armagh called Neil Vallely, I think is how you pronounce his second name. Niall Vallely. And he's a modern chap, still plugging away there. A wonderful concertina player. And to fill in with our theme tonight, I didn't even realise this when I was researching the guy. His most recent band that he's got going is called Bulia, which is the Irish for blow. Just like the
like a
wind.
It's been a stormy week, folks.
So we're going to play these set of tunes that he's written called Grab a Groove and Nina's. And we want to take a second to have a bit of a shout out to Nina. I hope she's watching from Virginia. Is Nina on tonight?
I haven't seen
She was on last week. So if she's on tonight or watches this back, hi Nina.
Lady plays the fiddle, yeah?
Yeah. She's fiddling along last week. So we'll give these two a go. They're in quare keys now for anyone playing along. The first one's
It's very futuristic.
First one's in B minor, and the second one is in F sharp minor.
But yeah, I mean, on the whistle they fall straight out on the fingers, you know?
The fingles.
The fingles.
I love it.
Fingles.
Lovely. Alright, there we go.
Future.
What do you make of those, Eddie?
Yeah, beautiful.
They're great, aren't they?
They actually fall right under the finger. I mean, I say that just having slightly messed them up a bit. But they're really easy on the banjo too. Yeah,
great. Like, they're great tunes.
They're very funky.
Thank you for sending those in, guys. That's great. It's good to get the modern tunes in as well. Right, so now are we going to move on to our star of the show here. The man, the legend.
I don't know if I could take it with him being in the room.
I know. We contacted Eddie and we were being asked for many weeks now to get this next tune, and I mean it's listed on the session as a waltz, and I guess maybe I don't know.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
But it's mostly played as a slow air. Which is what Eddie kindly did for us here. A beautiful recording. And Ben was just noting that when he was digging it up for replay here. It just sounds great. So we're going to try
it. I may have souped it up to some extent as well. It was a good palette to start with.
Yeah, so when we get something recorded as well as this, mine and Ben's job is to get as much out of the way so you can hear lots of Eddie. And then you guys can enjoy it playing at home. So,
and Yvonne that requested it.
It was Yvonne, yeah. If Yvonne's watching, this is your one here, hon.
Well, that was the thing. We saw the request there, and it's like, who plays that tune? None other.
Yeah. Are we at 4:35?
Six.
All right. Give us a second here, folks. We'll just make. making sure everything is sounding right.
The up and down of the temperature just makes all the instruments go bananas. And just like, why? Why?
All right, here we go. Here's Eddie and a slow air called In a Sheer. Program Eddie is with us here in studio and he's going to be hanging around for the post show chat there. That was beautiful.
Stunning.
So yeah. Nice, man. What a great recording too. So thank you, Eddie, for that one. We are coming near the end of the program here. We got another song here for you, and this is more just we're trying to keep in keeping with the windy and this blowing of the wind
and the moisture coming from the sky.
This song is a song I learned when I was in Galway off a Dutchman.
Typical.
And he used to sing these Irish songs in his heavy Dutch accent, but it was great. Is my good friend Robin Hay, who is still knocking around Ireland, I hope. I think he went back home to Holland for a while. But I'm going to sing this one for Robin. And this one is called The Mermaid, which apparently when you're out at sea, if you spotted a mermaid and she had a comb and a mirror in her hands, that meant your ship was going down. So, you know, they have a lot of these superstitions at sea. So I hope you enjoy this one. This was if anyone playing along, it's in the key of F. So whistle players, accordions, I suppose the C or harmonic.
Or the B flat.
Yeah. Or the B flat, yeah. Awesome. All right.
And the
5 minutes before we went on air, we're playing that. Cool. Don't know how it goes, but it's got an evocative story, so I managed to follow along.
Good on you. You just imagined that mermaid, didn't you?
Meow. Oh, sorry, wrong sound. What a mermaid.
Oh, that's great. So, folks, we really hope you enjoyed the show tonight. We want to say a special thank you to the players who gave up their time and sent in some great music to us.
Look, it's wonderful. It means a lot to us. It means a lot to everybody that's watching as well. So thanks for all your efforts.
So we're going to do a quick shout-out. We had some reels from Neville and Bindi. Thank you, guys. So we had some hornpipes from Eddie Nolan and Dennis. We had...
And Joycey,
yeah. Yes. Dibna and Kevin sent in those lovely modern jigs, and our very own Eddie Kavanagh here in the studio with a slow air. That was wonderful. So we're going to finish up the show tonight with a rollback of some lovely jigs from Dibna. And these ones are, I think, the first kind of set of jigs that I really fell in love with. So saying a big shout out to Dibna here. She's watching. Hey, how you doing, Dee?
And she plays the feces out of them.
You really are trying tonight, man.
I used to be a school teacher.
That is absolutely terrifying, sir. Oh, that's great. So this, of course, is the Listagun set with Aaron's Key and the Handsome Young Maiden. We hope you guys enjoyed the show. When we wrap tonight, we're going to have a bit of a chat out in the kitchen, out in Ben's kitchen there, and with Eddie and with Caroline. And grab a cup of tea and wait for the next live stream if you fancy it. If not, we will see you next Wednesday for the next episode of The Lot. Thank you guys for playing along and enjoying the music. And here's my favourite set of jigs. Ladies and gents, I hope you enjoyed the show. A big thank you to Caroline there at the helm. And we are the Broken Polkas. Thank you for playing along at home. And we'll be back next week with a whole lot more tunes and songs. And thank you to all the players. And we'll see you next week.
And Rio, Dibna, take us out.
You!